Raw Sports. Big Star. Stras Dean on the beat. And I go by the name of Izzy. Yeah. What you know about Big Star 2 Raw back in the street? Where we been, where we at, where we go? Just know he about to get back on his feet. Yeah, let a king sit back in the seat. We taking the playroom action to eat. Before there was a smack of a king of the doubt, we pull up on the block, put a rapper to sleep. We trendsetters, ain't no hater, no vendettas. He the forefather, that's 10 letters. Y'all stole footage, should've paid homage. Would've went better, that's fine, no. We killed it, broke it down and then we... Hey, what's up, y'all? Check it out. It's your boy, Big Star, man. You're now rocking with the best, RawSports.tv. This is Big Star's Lost Tapes, man. Just want to thank y'all for tuning in to another classic episode. Quick message to all my Big Star's Lost Tapes supporters. In this new year, 2016, man, I've definitely noticed that I have a major following that's been checking into the website, on YouTube, on the Raw Sports channel, following and really, really being faithful to the Big Stars Lost Tapes movement, man. So I appreciate y'all, you know, appreciate me and what it is that I do as far as preserving, you know, hoop culture around the country, man. So especially for you guys, just a heads up, I'm really turning it up here in 2016, man. So definitely look forward to consistent Big Stars Lost Tapes about like once a month, every 3 weeks, three weeks, you know, plus or minus a few. So definitely, and if you can, subscribe, make sure you subscribe to the YouTube channel. That way you'll get all the alerts and, you know, text messages, emails or whatever, whenever I drop something brand new. So you may, you know, make sure you stay up on it. You know what I'm saying? So another thing I'm about to do real quick, that's a little bit different than what I would do in the past. The Raw Sports Facts. I'm gonna just give them up right now real quick. Each game that I present, each classic, you know, throwback Big Stars Lost Tape, definitely has a lot of history around the game, whether it's the players that played in the game, the teams that were playing, the time period. So I'm gonna definitely, you know, give you all the Raw Sports Facts right before each game, just so that when I get done talking, it's not so much visuals and we can get straight into the game. So a few Raw Sports Facts before we get into this classic. Carver versus Simeon, 1985 Public League Championship game out of Chicago. Classic, you know what I'm saying? First thing I want to say about that is, if I'm not mistaken, I believe these are two homegrown programs, not any prep schools or anything like that. Carver's a city team. Simeon's a city team. That's one thing that I really respect, are city teams that keep their talent home, you know, guys that don't kind of shoot away. Whenever you have a powerhouse city team that can stay a powerhouse where everybody stays home, I respect that. The year was 1985. And you'll notice when you watch the game, there was no three-point line. All right, so for the younger generation that's watching this game, you're not going to see a three-point line. So don't think that, you know, nothing's wrong. It's just that this was 1985, and if you do your history like I did, in the 1987-88 season is when they introduced the three-point line to high school basketball across the country. And so if you made a shot beyond 19 feet 9 inches, that was, you know, considered 3 points. You'll notice also something. At the start of every quarter, they do a jump ball. I got to do my history on that to kind of see why or when that was changed to just doing the jump ball at the beginning of the game. But that was something else I noticed about this game. The shorts were, you know, much shorter than they are today. But if you'll notice, things are kind of coming full circle. The kind of shorter shorts, more comfortable so that your legs can have more ability to kind of, more freedom to move, is kind of coming back. The super baggy look is kind of like, you know, going out the door, it seems like. The players were really lean, strong. Everybody could jump. Everybody from the center to the point guard, everybody can shoot. So pay attention to everybody's form when they're shooting the rock. I'm sure that was like, it was much more fundamental back in the day, man. Everybody seemed to be much more fundamentally sound. Also a big piece around this game was Simeon, if everyone knows. If you've seen, I believe, the ESPN 30 for 30 joint, Ben Simmons played on this team, who was considered back in, you know, the 80s, 84, 85, going into his senior season, he was like the number one player in the country, like out of Chicago. And if everyone knows his story, that on November 21st, 1984, he was 17 years old. He was murdered, by a student from a nearby school or something like that. So actually, he didn't even get a, he was the number one player in the country going into his senior season, and he did not get a chance to play a senior high school basketball game. He was murdered like a day before his senior season was about to start. He was a legend. The two individuals that highlighting in this game were one of the best point guards in the world, as far as professional, high school, college, Tim Hardaway, who invented the killer crossover, Nick, who played for Carver, Simeon also featured NBA All-Star, Orlando Magic, Nick Anderson. So you'll hear the commentators talking about him and how awesome he was. Also, another fact that I found out, sorry I'm so long-winded, but I want to get the facts out, the World Sports facts out. Going back to Ben Wilson also played with music legend Art Kelly. Art Kelly was a basketball star out of Chicago. The story is, if you do your research, Art Kelly, he was supposed to play varsity in ninth grade. His music teacher, a lady by the name of Miss Lena McGlynn, encouraged him to get in the high school talent show. He sung "Ribbon in the Sky" by Stevie Wonder, killed the talent show, and I guess initially when she introduced or if she proposed to him, she wanted him to quit basketball. Actually, going back, she wanted him to quit basketball and start singing. I guess, you know, focus some more time on singing. He got upset. He was pissed off. Said, "I'll never do that." And killed the talent show, and I guess after the talent show he got saw the response, and you know, the rest was history. He kind of like ditched basketball until the 1997 year, when he was already an established singer. I guess he put singing aside for a while. He actually played pro ball. R. Kelly played for the Atlantic City Seagulls. He was a shooting guard, small forward. He won 3 USBL championships. Then I guess, you know, he said, "All right, I pretty much accomplished everything I needed to," and went back on to singing full time. So I think that's it for you guys. That's pretty much it, man. Those are the raw sports facts centered around this game. This is the 1985 Chicago Public League Championship game featuring Tim Hardaway. Shout out to you, Tim. Hopefully this film reaches you, man. You know, helping you to, you know, bring back some memories, man. You know, I'm preserving the culture for you, brother. And my man Nick Anderson. Also, one other thing. If anyone watching this film knows anybody else that was in this game, you know, their college careers, if any of the other players made the league or anything like that, leave a comment in the section, because a lot of times I miss a lot. So that's pretty much it, man. You know, y'all make sure you subscribe to the YouTube channel, and you know, definitely look forward to the next Big Stars Lost Tape. All right, holla at your boy. Peace.
City, Carver's Challengers against the Simeon Wolverines. I'm Tim Weigel, sitting next to Coach Ray Meyer. It sounds corny, but there's nothing like high school basketball. What an afternoon we've got in store for us.
Oh, this is going to be a great afternoon between two fine teams. We're going to witness a real well-played, hard-fought basketball game. And Simeon is used to winning. Carver's coming up here after a while.
The great Cassie Russell led Carver to its first city crown ever in 1962. And the team went all the way to Champaign to the state finals, where they lost by a point to Decatur. The next year, the Challengers were batshit in a dramatic one-point victory over Centralia. 22 years later, Carver is back again, challenging to be the best in the city. Nobody thought they were going anywhere at the beginning of the season, not even Coach Bob Walters. But 6'5" jumping jack Wade Jenkins, who was named most valuable player at the Centralia Christmas tournament when the unheralded Challengers stunned two rated teams, Cahokia and Fenton, and won the big trophy. Another junior starter is 5'5" defensive specialist Roderick Hudson. But the real catalyst of the Challenger team is senior guard Tim Hardaway, a four-year starter for Coach Walters. Hardaway is averaging better than 23 points a game, and he lit up the scoreboard for 45 in the quarterfinal victory over South Shore. If Hardaway gets hot, the Challengers could pull off yet another. Then on November 20th, tragedy struck. Ben Wilson became another victim of Chicago's senseless gang violence, and the school and community mourned the loss of a very special young man. Coach Bob Hambrick had to regroup his team, but with five new starters, Simeon pulled together and won the Rockford Thanksgiving tournament, and they've been winning ever since. The Wolverines' only loss this year came to top-rated and unbeaten Proviso West in that team's own Christmas tournament. Simeon's specialty is defense. They can intimidate inside and get their opponents looking sideways instead of at the basket. The Wolverines have a balanced attack, which has been beefed up considerably since Nelson Nick Anderson became eligible at mid-year after transferring from Prosser High School, where he was one of the city's top scorers a year ago. Simeon is loaded with talent from all over the city, and that's been a source of controversy for Coach Hambrick. But the Wolverines keep winning, and Simeon's reputation keeps growing. More of the good players will likely keep showing up on the doorstep of the Southside Vocational School. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome once again to today's 1985 Public League Basketball Championship game. And let's meet the starting lineups for these two fine teams, beginning first with the Carver Challengers. Starting at forward, a 6'2" junior, Jerry Smith. Also at forward, 6'6" senior, Caleb Davis. At center, a 6'5" junior, Wade Jam Jenkins. At guard, a 5'5" junior, Roderick Hudson. And another guard, number 10, 5'11" senior, Tim Hardaway. And now for the defending state champions, the Simeon Wolverines. Playing forward, here's 6'3" senior David Knight. Also at forward, 6'3" junior Eric David. The center, 6'5" junior Irving Small. At guard, a 6'2" junior Alan Gordon. And also at guard, a 5'8" sophomore, Dion Butler. And finally, the coach of the Simeon Wolverines, Mr. Robert Hambrick. All right, so there you have the starting lineups. We'll be back to play basketball right after this break. Nat Humphrey on the right, and they're about to toss up the opening tip-off for this Public League Championship game. Ray, the butterflies are floating a little bit, aren't they?
Yes, they are. We've been waiting. I'll tell you this, the crowd has got me so worked up for the ball game, I'm ready to play.
Well, I know you got a pretty mean two-handed set shot.
I haven't seen that in this day and age.
We've seen just about everything else. Wade Jenkins and Irving Small tip it off, and Jenkins wins the tip for Carver High School. The challenger's Tim Hardaway controlling the ball. Inside deep to Wade Jenkins, up and it's in. Carver off early.
Beautiful passing. Boy, he can jump. He surprised me.
He's only a junior, fine-looking player. All right, here's Simeon going to work on the Carver 1-2-2 zone. In deep to Eric David, up. Rolls off with the tip by Small, is also off, and Carver has the rebound. Controlled by number 14, Caleb Davis. Roderick Hudson with the jump shot. It's just off, and the rebound to Eric David of Simeon. Simeon up quickly. This is Deion Butler with a dribble. To David, in the corner to David Knight. Butler with the long shot, it's off. The rebound to Caleb Davis again for Carver. Pushing it up the floor is Tim Hardaway. Hardaway with the jumper, it's in. 4-0 Carver.
That was a beautiful shot. I didn't think that had a chance of going in.
Ray, he's an exciting player, about 25 points a game. And Simeon's in an early hole here. Alan Gordon with the ball. Penetrating. Off to Knight. Drives the baseline. Stripped of it by Hardaway.
He was out of bounds when he touched the ball. He'll go to Simeon out of bounds.
Ray, we're going to see a real, we see racehorse basketball is almost a cliche, but they will push the ball up and down the floor.
Yes, and we're seeing Carver pressing a little bit. Nice move.
That's Butler inside. It's off and tipped in by Eric David, number 24. 4-2 now, Carver leads.
David.
Both of these teams, Ray, will show a lot of pressure defenses.
Yes, it's a 1-3-1, but there, boy, they... Hardaway took a gamble and threw a long pass. He would have scored on it. It was just mishandled. It was a good pass.
Caleb Davis called for the walk on the play, giving Simeon with the ball and a chance to tie the game up. We're at about 6 minutes left in the first quarter. And Carver's got a 4-2 lead. That's Deion Butler, a little transfer from Mount Carmel High School, passing on. I'm sorry, Alan Gordon was the one who transferred from Mount Carmel. And Gordon has the ball now, in the corner tonight. And the Simeon forwards, tight zone defense for Carver. Gordon deep inside. Ball swatted away by Jenkins, and I think they're gonna call a goaltend.
Yes, Jenkins hit it after.
A terrific basketball game shaping up. 4-4 is the score, Carver and Simeon. Carver taking it out onto their own basket.
Jim, both teams are using a 1-3-1, three-quarter trapping defense. But so far, both teams handle the trap very easily.
They've seen a lot of it this year. It's a very popular defense in the public league. They like to make things happen. And speaking of guys who make things happen, Tim Hardaway with the ball now. One of the best guards in the city and perhaps the state of Illinois. He's got the ball again now. He's working low. He shoots the jumper. Yes. Oh.
Short dribble to his right and a jump shot. He is a fine-looking basketball player.
That was a possible violation, but it turned into a turnover anyway. Hardaway with the ball, takes the middle up. Yes, no, it's off the back rim. Jenkins tries for the rebound, unsuccessful. The ball's out of bounds to Carver. You know, I'm getting so used to watching Hardaway make those, I anticipated that was going to find nothing but net.
Hudson did a very smart thing then. He blocked off the man so the ball would go out of bounds and Carver would get it off.
When you're short, you got to be smart, Ray. And this kid is smart. Roderick Hudson at 5'8" tall. Here's Tim Hardaway, who's 5'10". Down low to Caleb Davis, working on a couple of players. Jerry Smith gets the ball instead. He puts it in, and it counts.
Wade Jenkins has showed me a lot of power and strength then. He got hit while he was up in the air and still followed it through and made the basket.
Irving Small was called to the personal. Jerry Smith with a chance at the three-point play. And Carver sitting on an 8-4 lead. Ray, Bob Hambrick likes to bring in his star player, Nick Anderson, off the bench. He might have to bring him off a little earlier because Carver's hurting Simeon a little bit underneath.
Yes, Jenkins has great leaping ability, and it's a quick jump. He doesn't have to wind up. He gets up in the air in a hurry.
Right, here's the pressure on the ball. Knight has it on the missed steal, and it's in. Cutting the Carver lead now to 9-6. David Knight, who's been in a shooting slump lately, Ray. He was their top scorer for a while, and he's gotten a little cold. If he gets hot, Simeon's in great shape. This is Hardaway, double team. Now it's back off time. Hardaway inside to Jenkins. Jenkins working the middle. Up and it's in. Oh. And we have another three-point play. And I believe that foul was also on Small. David was given credit for the foul, or the blame, I should say. Take a look at the replay. Now, that's what you're talking about, Ray, that quick jump that Jenkins has.
He gets up in the air in an awful hurry.
And he has a chance for another three-point play. It's off, and the rebound to David. So that makes the score 11-6, Carver over Simeon, with 4:07 left to play. This is Deion Butler over to Eric David.
You're right, Jim. Anderson's over at the scoring table right now.
Yeah, they've got to bring him inside. Gordon with the dribble and the shot. Bounces out the rebound to Caleb Davis, who loses control, and it's picked up by Wade Jenkins. He is a tough. Releasing to Hardaway now.
He's quick for the ball.
This is the shot by Hudson. Off. Rebound to Eric David. He's been a force underneath for Simeon. 6'3" ball player. A lot of these Simeon players, Ray, are underclassmen. They're going to be terrific next year, but they're worried about this year right now. And the basket by David Knight.
David Knight.
And we have an 11-8 basketball game. Carver on top and with the ball. Now this, of course, is right where the defense wants the ball, over in that corner. He quickly gets it back into the middle where it belongs. Hardaway inside to Jenkins with a move. Up, off the basket, no good. This is Knight with the rebound, slowing it down. Back to Deion Butler, the point guard, who'll set up the Simeon offense. To Alan Gordon, to David Knight, drives the baseline. It's up and it's just out. Ball out of bounds to Simeon.
Boy, Knight is very quick along the baseline. What you're noticing here, Carver's released their press. They're dropping back into a straight 1-3-1 zone. And I like the way Carver is attacking the 1-3-1 press. They're coming up with three men across the center line.
Now, as we predicted, or perhaps commented about, Nick Anderson has been brought into the game. He's a 6'5½" junior, one of the best players in the city of Chicago, who was made eligible at mid-year when he transferred from Prosser High. That's Nick with the ball, and he's called for a walk.
Yes, he tried to get position in there, and he went backward.
Public League basketball action. Basket with an 11-8 lead. With 2:35 to go in the first quarter, Simeon's Wolverines, defending state champions, trying to defend their city crown right now. This is Hardaway working on Deion Butler. Hardaway looking for the shot, up, off the front rim, no good. Nick Anderson with the rebound. He seems to make a difference in there, Ray. He has a lot of size and poise.
Oh, yes, there's no question. He's a very strong individual.
This is David out to Butler. Butler back to David on the baseline, looking for something inside. Out front to Butler, looking for the shot. Passes it off. It's stripped of him by Roderick Hudson. The little Carver guard did a nice job on defense. Here's Hardaway with the hesitation move inside. He's still trying to get it in. He's trying for a third attempt, and he draws the foul. Boy, that's aggressive basketball. The little guy takes it inside.
Really aggressive in there. Oh, amazing how he was called on. He was fouled by Irvin Small.
Irving didn't like that call too much, but Irving Small. That's going to...
If Hardaway starts to hit, Simeon's going to be in a lot of trouble because he moves his body. He's very graceful. Simeon played him for the charge, and he just floated away from the charge.
Interesting call. They're going to give it to him out of bounds. He was not in the act of shooting, apparently. This is Hardaway inside to Caleb Davis. He puts it up and in. You saw with a slight fake, he drew the two Simeon defenders off their feet, and he put it in for a 13-8 Carver lead. This is Eric David with the ball back to Butler. A lot of pressure. Jenkins almost got the steal, but David controls. Down in the corner. Here's Knight with a shot from the baseline. A little long. Irving Small up for it. Can't control. Caleb Davis brings it down. It's partially blocked, but he controls to Hardaway. Here's Hardaway on the move with the jumper. A little short. Rebound to Simeon, but stripped away by Hardaway.
Hardaway is all over the court.
Jenkins has the ball. deflected. Let's get the call. We're going to call a walk.
We call a walk. Hardaway is not afraid to throw the high lob pass inside. He does a great job of throwing it.
All right, with a score 13-8, with 48 seconds to go in the first quarter, we'll be back after this timeout. Carver fans applauding their 13-8 advantage at this point in the basketball game. Simeon has the ball.
You know that Carver are changing their defense. They're in the 1-3-1. They extend it, then they drop back, then they come up. Simeon is doing similar things on defense, but Carver seems to be more aggressive at this time.
Butler penetrates. The ball's mishandled. That's Knight over in the corner. Back to Nick Anderson at the key. Butler back tonight. He's got the jumper. Left-hand shot is in. 13-10 to score now with 25 seconds to go in the first quarter.
Knight has got a nice jump shot, and he can take the ball to the basket. He's a fine basketball player.
He looks like he's got more confidence than he had in the last couple of games. This is Jerry Smith driving the lane. Passes low to Davis. He's called for the walk. Critical turnover, takes the basket away from Carver. And here's Simeon now with 10 seconds to go and a chance to slice into that three-point Carver lead.
Smith had a beautiful pass to Davis.
Here's Simeon in a hurry. Knight looks inside, he finds Anderson. The shot's up and in. And that's gonna do it for the end of the first quarter. Carver sitting on a one-point lead. We'll be back with more excitement right after this. There was an infraction on the opening tip of the second quarter.
Wade Jenkins jumped too soon. He tapped the ball too soon. I was worried about the first tip. He jumped very quickly then.
Ray, I think he sort of captures what all of us are feeling, a little anxiety, want to get things in a hurry. Inside, Eric David up with the basket and gives Simeon the lead, their first lead in the basketball game.
That was remarkable because he threw the ball into the wing and then went right in the middle and up to the basket. No one covered him.
Okay, so for the first time all afternoon, Carver High School is behind, and they might go down further. Here's Butler on the drive. Up, no good, but the rebound by Irving Small is also off. Small for another try, and Carver comes out with a basketball. Rod, Tim Hardaway on the move. In the middle. Knocked away by Butler, and they give it to Carver.
Well, Simeon had a chance to advance that lead up to another 2 points, so missed an easy one.
Ray, I approve of this kind of officiating. They let them play when they get inside there. There's no, no pity-pat fouls.
I like it. I think I like this better than some of the college games.
Ray, I always thought you were a big fan of the official.
Oh, I am. I've been officiating for years. There goes that lob pass in again.
Just off the rim, and they're going to call some offensive goaltending.
Offense.
So discount that basket, although it never even went in, and Simeon still sitting on a one-point lead with about 7 minutes to play in the first half. Right now we're going to see Carver's first substitution of the game. Marvin Thompson comes in. Marvin's got a little beef. He's 6'3", 194, a senior, and he'll go inside in place of Jerry Smith. He's over there now on Eric David. Make that David Knight. David Knight working the baseline. This is Butler, back to Knight. Knight from the baseline, just off the rim. Look at Jenkins get up. He can't control the ball. Eric David brings it out and puts it in. They're gonna call Caleb Davis on the foul.
Caleb Davis.
A terrific play by Eric David. He's been very impressive today. There's the replay, coach. Look at Jenkins, way above the crowd, but he can't control it. Little garbage picking by David, and he puts it in.
David is a fine basketball player. He has great nose for the ball. He's always in the right spot at the right time.
And he converts the three-point play, giving Simeon a 17-13 advantage.
This game so far?
Well, I think Simeon have a great team, but Carver looks real competitive, so it's pretty close right now, but I'm going with Simeon.
You're nervous against Georgetown for Thursday?
Oh, no, we're not nervous. Me and the coach right here sitting back, relaxed, and we're going to go to Georgetown and play real hard. I feel we can beat them.
Okay, thank you very much, Al Frederick.
Okay.
Back to you, Tim.
All right, Jim Rose. And Al Frederick Hughes, the leading scorer in the nation from Loyola's Ramblers. And he's right, Ray. Carver is competitive, but they're in an interesting position right now. They've really almost got to come down and put an end to this Simeon spurt.
Carver's a competitive team, but they made two mistakes down on the other end, and Simeon, a fine basketball team, converted on both of them.
There's a reach-in foul on Deion Butler. It's very difficult to strip Tim Hardaway of the ball. They did it once, but he's an exceptional ball handler.
Well, he puts his body between the ball and the defender. He protects the ball very well, and he's strong. His upper body strength looks tremendous.
Incidentally, Jerry Smith is back in the ball game right now, and Carver looks like they're going with the big lineup. They've taken little Rod Hudson out. Inside, it was forced by Marvin Thompson. He couldn't get it in there. Another mistake that you're talking about, Coach. And here's Simeon with a chance to go up by six. And just as we speak, he's bringing Rod Hudson to the scoring table. Bob Walters, the Carver coach, wants to get his little guard back in. This is Knight with a basket.
Boy, he throws a beautiful shot, beautiful follow through.
That's made a big difference, Ray. He's been real cold the last couple of Simeon games. They said he was in a shooting slump. No slump today. He's got 6 points so far, and Eric David has nine. Make that 8 points for Knight. Nine for David. And eight for Knight. And here's Carver down by six. Gonna have to make something happen right here. Hardaway with the ball. Working the point. Driving right. Stops and shoots. It's off too long. Nick Anderson with the rebound. Down court quickly to Knight. Knight stops, shoots. It's short, but I think he drew the foul.
He was fouled. He was fouled by Roderick Hudson. Simeon defense has tightened up considerably. They're more aggressive, and they're not letting Carver handle the ball outside the way they want to handle it. And Carver is...
So we've got Rod Hudson and Stacy Samuels playing the guard positions as he's going to give Tim Hardaway a little rest. And this is Knight with a chance to convert a pair. First one's in.
Hardaway's taken a couple of shots that were questionable or judgment, and I think that's why he came out of the ball game.
Incidentally, if you're wondering about the number 25 on every Simeon jersey, that, of course, the number of Ben Wilson, the Simeon star player who was tragically killed last year. This is Caleb Davis rebounding the missed free throw, and Simeon's lead stays at 20-13. This is Jerry Smith working with the ball. Rod Hudson bringing it across, back to Smith, back to Hudson. Stacy Samuels now with the ball. This is Hudson with the long one. Just in and out. Rebound to Knight. Down court quickly to Anderson. He doesn't jam. He just puts in the layup. It counts the same on the scoreboard, a 22-13 Simeon advantage, and the Wolverines are really strutting their stuff. We'll be back with more exciting basketball action right after this timeout. Outside school has just jumped out to a 9-point lead, and Ray, an interesting, no, not so interesting if you're from Carver, but the Challengers have not scored since the second quarter began.
Well, and they're forcing Hardaway. They're giving him more pressure, more man-to-man pressure, and he's forcing up a couple of shots. And Simeon, when he missed it, Simeon is going right down and scoring.
There you see the graphic. Simeon has scored 10 times, and Carver has zipped for the second quarter. And that accounts for a 9-point Simeon advantage. This is Wade Jenkins getting the ball over the timeline. Hardaway is back in now with the ball. They've got to have him in there doing what he's been doing all season long. For instance, scoring 25 points a game. This is the shot by Hudson. Nothing but net. And it's a 22-15 game as Carver gets its first 2 points of the second quarter. Up the middle to Irving Small, and I think they're going to call a half-court violation.
That's right. If you start, it's where you start in basketball. He started in the front court and landed in the back court.
A lot of time these kids in the pressure situations forget where they are. And he did straddle the line after he caught the ball. Okay, here's Hardaway in the offensive zone now. Hudson looking for another shot. Inside to Jerry Smith. Shoots it up, off the rim, no good. Rebound to David Knight. He's been doing it on both ends of the floor, offensively and defensively, and he's controlling the ball right now. Still on the dribble.
Defense, they're playing man-to-man.
Jenkins missed the ball as he went for the steal. Anderson took it in unmolested for the layup, and we're back to a 9-point Simeon lead.
He came up on the wrong side. When the ball's that low, you have to come up from the basket side.
Score is 24-15 right now. Here's Knight on the drive. Past Hardaway. Knight looks for the shot, passes it up. Fakes, shoots. Off the rim, no good. Jenkins with the rebound, protecting the ball underneath. Hardaway controlling, inside to Caleb Davis. Fakes, shoots, good. And it's 24-17 now, with 3:32 to go in the half.
Simeon playing very smartly. When Hardaway gives up the ball, they come out and they try to deny him the ball, deny the ball coming back to him.
This is Nick Anderson, who's been a force since he entered the game in the first quarter. Hardaway guarding Knight very closely. This is Eric David down low to Irving Small. The turnaround is good. He's very effective inside. He's a little slight of build, but he makes his presence felt. Very graceful big man.
Well, you see in basketball, in particular defense, you never give position and the ball. And that time, the man did.
This is Hudson with a jump shot. It's long. There's a call. It's going to go against, apparently, Hudson. There you see Bob Walters, the coach at Carver.
I think it went against Caleb Davis. He pushed off trying to get position to rebound.
All right, with a score 26-17, 2:53 to go in the half. Simeon's going to have the ball under its own basket. And right now, I would say, Ray, they've definitely taken command of the game, and it's up to Carver to take it back for him.
Well, Carver's going to press him all over the court. Carver haven't looked good in man-to-man, and they got behind on a couple of mistakes, and now they're playing a pressing defense. They're going all over man-to-man.
It's Hardaway going for the steal and not getting it. This is Butler. Working on Rod Hudson. The two little men going head-to-head. Over in the corner, Eric David down low to Nick, David Knight was wide open.
David Knight's man took his eyes off of him and went watching the ball. He went foul watching and got caught.
Knight's got 10 points, and Simeon sitting on an 11-point lead. Ray, I really didn't expect this. I think that the Simeon is really showing the power that perhaps they didn't show against Dunbar. Nice move inside by Jenkins, but it's no good. Small with the rebound, and Simeon in control again.
Well, they're doing a little better on offense. They're getting better shots now. Before, all those shots were coming from out. Now they're getting inside.
Boy, they're really into their rhythm now, as you say.
Oh, boy.
Jenkins going for the block, but he got a little bit of Irving Small's hand instead. And Small will go to the line.
You can't give him the position that they're giving him and letting him get the ball right under the basket. It's very, very difficult.
Ray, you're obviously right. Carver is a zone team, and they're not as effective when they're playing man-to-man. Witness the easy basket by Knight. But when you're in a come-from-behind position, you almost have to play man to catch up.
The game situation has dictated they go man-to-man. They can't stay in the zone or Simeon's saying to hold the ball.
First free throw by Small is good. A little bit of a misnomer. Irving Small is anything but small. He's about 6'6". And he misses the second free throw. Jenkins pulls it off. Carver's got to make something happen here.
They need to have something on this possession or they're going to dig a deeper hole for themselves.
Well, they've scored only four times in this quarter. Hardaway's trying to make things happen, but this shot is up and off the rim, no good. Knight with the rebound. Simeon controlling. This is Butler.
They're doing a good job on Hardaway. They're forcing his shot and making him throw it a little higher than he normally wants to do it.
Irving Small with the jump shot. Off the rim, no good. Stacy Samuels pulls it down. Nick Anderson going for the rejection, and he got the foul instead. He took down Jerry Smith.
Jerry had a wide open layup, and probably he could have been a little quicker getting the shot away. Nick came from a long way to block that, or I shouldn't say block it. He fouled him. But that was the first indication that we've seen that Carver took a rebound and went down the court and tried to score. They need to get some baskets in transition.
Well, let's see if they can get some baskets, and we'll have the answer right after. David Knight has 11 points for Simeon, and Eric David has 9 points. 20 points between them. Nick Anderson has chipped in with about 4.
Well, they're forcing Hardaway's shot, but Carver has had a lot of balls up there that didn't drop for him. And you know, in basketball, one team spurts and then the other team spurts. Carver has to get a spurt here before the half.
First free throw is good by Jerry Smith.
That's what you call a funnel shot. It went all around and then dropped it. If Carver could get the score down to eight or below by halftime, they'd be in good shape.
Well, that time Marvin Thompson and Wade Jenkins had a chance to pull down the rebound, and they knocked each other off of it, and Simeon controls.
That's what's happening to Carver today. The ball isn't bouncing right for him.
Now they're going to call a blocking foul on Hardaway. He tried to get position.
Boy, Hardaway was very, very aggressive defensively then, but Anderson is a very well poised. As he's only a junior, Tim, he's going to have a great, great career next year. Not a career in 1 year, but he's going to be a great college basketball player.
Yeah, 1-1 free throw for David Knight. He's had a terrific first half. First free throw is perfect.
I like Knight very well. They got Anderson, a junior. This is the only senior on the ball club. He is a fine basketball player.
It's really unbelievable when you think this is an all-junior team. Knight hits again, and it's 31-18 with a minute to go in the half. One can only shudder to think how good Simeon will be next year. Right now, Carver's worried about how good they are this year. And they've got to do something here. It's 31-18 with 50 seconds to play. Hardaway controls. Down low to Rod Hudson, who puts it up, partially blocked by Nick Anderson. And they're going to call a foul on Eric David.
They're both in the bonus. I think they have to go down. It's a bonus. I think Carver, in order to get back in the game, they can't try to make it all up at one time. What they're doing is one pass and a shot. Simeon seems to be more poised, and they're in control of the game, and they know it. They're playing with a lot of confidence.
Ray Jenkins has been a little quiet this half. You can hear him there, though, as he makes that free throw. Jenkins with 5 points. The first points of the second quarter.
They're not moving the ball around on offense. It's one pass and a shot, so he hasn't been in the ball game.
All right, he hits them both. It's a 31-20 basketball game with 38 seconds to play. This is Butler with the ball. There's a little of the pushing and shoving underneath as Simeon sets up for what could be the last half, or the last shot of the first half.
They are playing for the last shot. They're running. Running the clock down. Oh,
Irving Small is loose underneath, and he hits it. 33-20, Simeon leads, and this will be the last shot of the first half if Carver can get it off. Hardaway with the ball, moves inside, passes down, beautiful pass off, and the basket is good. Marvin Thompson on the drive with a great feed from Hardaway.
That was great feed. If Hardaway starts doing that, because every time he moves with the ball, he's drawing people to him. He draws a crowd, and if he starts giving up the ball, there'll be some three men running around the basket. There's only 3 seconds to go.
He did a great job of protecting the ball there, and it's a real nice momentum builder for Carver. They're still way behind.
Well, if he gets this free throw, they'll go in at halftime only 10 down, and that's not bad. They're still in the ball.
It could have been a lot worse. Incidentally, Eric David has 3 fouls, and that could be a factor because he's one of Simeon's better board people. Free throw is good. 10-point game. Ball in quickly. Tony Rice makes the move, and he walked. And Carver may get a chance to fire one more prayer at the basket.
All they can do is throw it in, and as soon as it touches someone's hands, the clock starts. He's got to shoot it as soon as the man gets the ball. He's got to shoot it right now.
Nice defense. The shot is just off.
That was right there.
Marvin Thompson. All right, it's a 33-23 basketball game. And we're here at halftime of the Public League Finals. And let's go down to Jim Rose right now at courtside. Jim?
Well, I'll tell you, a 33-23 score for the Simeon Wolverines. It's obvious that that second half, that second quarter surge that they put on, scoring 14 straight points, is what put them in command of this basketball game. We're waiting for Bob Walter to come over right now to come and talk with us about that first half for the Carver Challengers. And, Coach, let me have the microphone here. Yeah, Tim Hardaway came out, had a great first quarter, but he came out in the second quarter, and Bob Hambrick put a man-to-man defense on him and shut him down somewhat.
Well, we're going to make that adjustment at halftime. They made a very wise move defensively. We were just trying to stay in the ball game until halftime so we can make some adjustments. I think we'll be okay in the second half.
What did you think? They came out, scored 14 straight points, four points at the end of the first quarter, and then 10 straight on you in the second quarter.
Well, this is a typical Simeon Carver matchup. This is the way we usually play. But the game usually go down to the wire. We're not that worried right now.
Will it be Hardaway that'll carry you in the second half?
It'll be one of the Carver challenges.
All right.
It's been different people all year.
Okay, Bob. Thank you very much.
My pleasure.
Okay. Well, Bob Walter, the coach of the Carver Challengers, talking with us here.
Elgin coach Bill Chesborough going after career win number 698. He's the winningest active coach in the state. The winner of that game will play in the second afternoon quarterfinal against either the Aurora East Tomcats, coached by Ernie Cavisto, or Rockford Boylan. Now, two downstate teams will be matched up in one of the evening quarterfinals. The winner of the Ottawa-Peoria-Richwoods game plays the winner of Carbondale versus Cahokia. Quite a year for Peoria-Richwoods. They won the state's Class 5A football title, and their girls' basketball team is undefeated and rated a top state contender. Now, the other evening quarterfinal at Evanston High will feature two Cinderella teams, both long shots to win the state tournament. Hersey High from Arlington Heights and Carmel from Mundelein. Carmel has never been down to the state before. Hersey only once, when they were led by a fellow by the name of Dave Corzine, who is now, of course, a Chicago Bull. Now, their opponent will be come out of what may be the best super sectional matchup at all. Tonight at Hinsdale between Mount Carmel of the Catholic League, led by Melvin McCants, who is headed for Purdue next year, and the Leiden Eagles, who last Friday night pulled off one of the tournament's biggest upsets. Now, Eagle fans from Leiden had every reason to be excited as their team stunned top-rated Proviso West. Leiden trailed for most of the game, but number 22, Bernie Tompa, one of the heroes in the comeback. He had two key three-point plays, including the one that sent it into overtime. Just 10 seconds left. Dino DeVeneri drives the baseline, scores, and draws the foul for another three-pointer to win the ballgame. Proviso's dream of going to Champaign had shattered, as well as their 28-game winning streak. Tough loss for Proviso West. Norm Goodman's Leiden Eagles won it 64-62 in overtime to run their record to 27-1 in a game that they will never forget. And remember, Proviso West, the team that beat Simeon in the Christmas tournament, the only loss for the defending state champions. Well, coming up, a special feature
and in the NBA. But the boom era of city basketball began in the 1960s when Cassie Russell sprang out larger than life from Carver High School. At 6'5", 200 pounds, he had the size of a forward, but he was quick enough to play guard. Russell went on to the University of Michigan just when college basketball was going big time. Cassie became Michigan's all-time leading scorer, and after a long NBA career, he continues as player coach in the Continental Basketball League, hoping one day for a head coaching stint back in the NBA. The Russell story brought college recruiters to Chicago's public league in droves, and city products began showing up in remote outposts all across the United States. In 1978, Westinghouse superstar Mark Aguirre became the first Super Blue Chipper to stay home for college and play at DePaul. Aguirre led the Blue Demons to the NCAA Final Four as a freshman, and he was joined by another public league player, Terry Cummings from Carver. And together they led DePaul's emergence as a national powerhouse. Both Aguirre and Cummings have gone on to stardom in the NBA, providing examples for the thousands of youngsters playing in the city league. But for every shooting star like Cummings, Aguirre, Russell, and Kerr, there are dozens of good young Chicago athletes who are using their basketball skills to upgrade themselves and their community.
The number that make the pros is a very, very small number, as we can all see, but it's a good thing to shoot at as long as, once more, it is consistent with the regular mission of the school. The school athletes are the key to this whole thing. You get 800-900 kids that go to a game each time. So I think
every Saturday morning at Cobb Hall on the University of Chicago campus, you'll find dozens of them from public, grade, and high schools across the city.
You know, I couldn't play sports if I didn't get my academic standings.
I expect Simeon in a close one.
All right, thank you very much, Coach. Let's go back to Tim and Ray.
All right, JR and Joey Meyer. He looks familiar, doesn't he, Coach?
I remember seeing that man before. Carver made up 4 points in the third quarter. They got to make six points in this half.
Tough break for Carver right there. Jerry Smith going high for the ball, lost his balance and was called for the walk.
The rule book states you can't go to the floor with the ball.
And that's exactly what he did. So Simeon controls. Every possession is a critical one right now. This is Butler working on Rod Hudson. Eric David with the ball and four fouls. Releases to David Knight. Carver's still in a man-to-man now. This is Knight inside to Eric David. Loses control, brings it up. Just off with the rebound by Mark Bradley and rolls it in. Oh, a big basket by the sophomore off the bench. 48-40 now with 7:20 to play.
That was a big possession.
This is Hudson taking it down low. Quickly inside to Smith, who can't find the handle. Makes the dive and gets the foul.
That's what they have to avoid, though, Jim. They got in no hurry. There was no place to throw that ball.
Now, Bob Walters is talking to Wade Jenkins, his big man. I think what he's probably telling him is to do a little
bit. 8-point deficit in a hurry, and it was a mistake.
This is David Knight, leading scorer today for Simeon. He's at the free throw line with a bonus, and he gets it by making the first one. Giving Simeon now a 9-point advantage. There you see him. He's right on his season average, 17 points.
Simeon answered the challenge very well there.
Yes.
At the start of this quarter.
Second free throw is good as well, and it's now a 50-40 game. And just like that, Simeon's taken right over the command that they seem to have lost at the end of the third quarter. Knight with 18 points now. Rod Hudson with the shot, just misses. This is, of course, Ben Wilson's mother watching the action, and she just watched her Simeon team get the rebound. Carver had a couple of chances to score and failed, and Simeon has a 10-point lead in the ball. Eric David sitting on the ball and getting it back now to Deion Butler. Butler working against Rod Hudson. 5-9 against 5-5. Butler passes off to Eric David. The drive, no good, but the rebound is up. Twice missed by Mark Bradley. Had a chance to put it down and couldn't do it. And Carver's come back out now, trying to whittle away at the Simeon advantage. This is Rod Hudson to Tim Hardaway and back to Hudson. Hudson moving it into the point area. Hardaway with the shot. Off the board, no good. Caleb Davis has the rebound and the basket. Caleb Davis, a 6'7" senior. I think they're going to call the offensive foul.
A good call. Carver is more effective offensively when Hardaway gives off the ball and moves over to the wing. And then when he gets it back, he's in scoring position where when he's way out on top, he's too far away from the basket. Here comes Smallback.
All right, with a score, Simeon 50, Carver 42.
On the floor,
enjoying an 8-point advantage, and there are the Carver challengers. And Ray, it's an overused sports talk, but Carver really hasn't quit. They really have managed to stay in the game and showed a lot of poise in class.
They're doing a nice job. Coach Walters has made the transition and putting Hardaway on the wing, and that's been more their most effective weapon. When he's out here with the ball, he's not effective.
Well, let's see what he's going to do. He's trying to take the ball to the wing. He gets it off to Jerry Smith, who shoots, misses. Rebound inside to Caleb Davis with a hook, no good, and Simeon controls the ball. Irving Small brings it down.
They had two great shots then, but the ball won't drop. Carver has to play man-to-man these last 5.5 minutes. They can't afford to sit back anymore.
They're pressing him nose-to-nose. This is Butler, fine ball handler. Ooh. Hudson almost took it away from him, and he draws the foul. Nice aggressive defense. The kid's got to go for the steal.
Oh, they played it well. No disgrace in that. He's really going after him. Hudson tipped that ball, but fortunately for Simeon, it went to someone else's hands. It's just in the third quarter.
I'm not going anywhere. Anderson with the shot off the back rim. Jerry Smith controls the rebound. A bit shakily, but he did in fact get the ball. And here's Hardaway operating now against the Simeon defense. Hardaway dribbles right, looking for the shot, takes it. Off the backboard, no good. Rebound to Anderson for Simeon. And here's Butler on the attack.
He's nowhere near effective out on the top as he is on the wing.
This is Nick Anderson looking for somebody underneath. Hudson with the steal attempt failing. Butler passing off to Irving Small, who spins, shoots again. Once again, no good. Rebound to Caleb Davis. Release to Hardaway. Carver on the move. Hardaway takes it up, scores. It counts.
It counts.
And I think they fouled Irving Small out of the game.
Yes, that's his fifth foul. Hardaway very smartly protected the ball with his body and went up. I think Small was a little slow getting a defensive position. With four fouls, he'd have been a lot better off to let him make the basket.
Well, Coach, you said don't anybody go anywhere, and that's certainly proof of that right there. It's now the score is 50-44, and Hardaway has fouled out Simeon's big man, and now he has a chance to cut the lead to five.
Well, they miss Small when he's not in there. Well, you got 4:37 to go. Both teams are in the bonus, and it's 6 points deficit for Carver. Although Simeon is a well-poised team, they're not going to quit. I mean, they'll come down the floor as they've answered every challenge so far of Carver.
Hardaway's free throw is good, and it's a five-point basketball game. With 4:37 to go, Deion Butler has the ball. That's what's made this game so interesting, Ray. Ebb and flow, Carver always coming back, Simeon regaining control. Let's see if they can do it here. They go right away to Anderson. Shots him. Wow.
He posts up very strongly. Simeon answers the challenge. Now here comes, it's a very important possession for Carver.
Hardaway takes it down low. He has Davis underneath, but he scores himself. Boy, he looks very good this quarter, Ray.
He's taken over the basketball game.
With 4 minutes to go. 4 minutes left in the season for one of these teams. There's the foul call there on Tim Hardaway.
No, I don't think it was on Hardaway. I thought it was on 53. It was on Jerry Smith, guarding a pivot man under there.
A breaking system.
Ray, before we go any farther, I'd like to acknowledge our crack spotters here. James Randall from Simeon High School and Anthony White from Carver. Thanks, guys. You're excited, right? We're right into a ball game. The answer was yes, folks.
This has been a very exciting ball game. Simeon seems to have a wealth of talent, but Hardaway is leading a surge here.
All right, Anderson with a very important free throw, giving Simeon now a six-point advantage.
That's the way they started, and that's the way they're still even for the fourth quarter now.
This is Anderson going for his eighth point of the game. He doesn't get it. It's off the front rim. Marvin Thompson with the rebound, trying for the outlet, and he finds Hardaway. This is Hardaway working the left side. In low to Wade Jenkins. Jenkins is there for the shot in the basket. 53-49 with 3:41 left in the game. Deion Butler working on Ron Hudson. Butler all the way. In and out of the free throw area. Down low to David Knight. Shot is good.
Beautiful reverse and beautiful pass from Butler. Ruff. Wonderful reverse there.
First class play all the way, and it's 55-49. And this is Hardaway looking to get it right back. He does.
He keeps throwing that shot. Oh, there's a foul, blocking foul.
All right, that's 20 points for Hardaway.
And that was a foul on Hudson then.
And Butler's going to get one and one. 55-51 with 3:08 to play.
Deion Butler is a very important cog in the Simeon offensive. He dribbles the ball.
It really is true. He works the bench well. The entire roster gets involved. But right now, Butler's the man on the spot. He sinks the first free throw.
He plays under control all the way. I like a player that does that.
You know, Hudson's 5'5 and very quick. I think Butler's a little quicker. At least at times he appears to be quicker.
Well, if he isn't quicker, he's just as quick. I would say he's probably a little quicker.
Well, here he makes both free throws, and he gives Simeon now a six-point lead with 3:01 left in the game. This is Hardaway trying to make it happen again. He's got 20 points.
He better get rid of the ball.
Well, there's going to be a foul called on number 22, David Knight.
Oh, boy, that's his fourth, I believe. His second?
They claim it's his second foul. It perhaps is a mistake. I thought I had Knight for three fouls at least going into that one, but...
Maybe they're right. Maybe they're mistaken.
It was a confusing foul because I saw Jenkins hit the floor, but this is going to be Rod Hudson shooting the free throw and missing it. Ooh, a big miss for Carver.
Yes, he had a chance to pick up 2 points with the clock stop.
This is Butler working the ball over to Anderson. Anderson to David Knight.
They're in a stalling zone now. They're just moving the ball.
Simeon's had a lot of practice with this, Ray. They've been in a lot of lead positions late in the game, so they run this very well. This is Knight releasing to Butler. 2:22 left to play in the game. 57-51 to score. There's a double team on Butler, and Hardaway gets the foul.
They were really, they're in control game now. They're trying to go stall it out, put a little time on the clock.
Bob Hambrick is upset with something. He's a very enigmatic coach, Ray. He can be very cool in the face of fire, and then similar to Bob Knight, some little thing bothers him. He gets very excited, and here comes a timeout called by the Carver Challengers with a lead of 57-51 for Simeon and 2:18 left in the game. We'll be right back.
For Bola Wines, Franco Bola.
Sono Franco Bola.
With 2:18 to play, Ray, Deion Butler has a couple of very important free throws, or at least one very important free throw.
Two free throws, Tim, I think they're in the driver's seat now, because Harbor doesn't get any breakaway baskets. Neither they get many tip-ins on the offensive board.
Butler's first free throw is good. Ray, you were explaining while we were off camera why Coach Hambrick was upset.
He was upset because they had three men across out at midcourt, and they were not penetrating with the ball. He wanted them to penetrate and force Carver into a mistake.
Well, they don't penetrate the basket there, but the missed free throw is rebounded by Simeon on a very important board.
Yeah,
and they have the ball now with just 2:08 left to play and a seven-point advantage. David Knight, oh, the steal by Hudson. He's got the breakaway. 58-53, a five-point game.
That's why he didn't want him to play around with the ball at midcourt. He wanted to go in a little bit.
Well, Rod Hudson showed us plenty of quickness there, didn't he, Coach?
He showed a lot of quickness and a lot of anticipation.
1:40 left in the game. 58-53 the score. Simeon with the ball. Anderson prevents the steal. And they work it over now to Eric David to David Knight. All right, there's the penetration. Coach Hambrick wanted it. There's the steal. Coach Walters wanted from Carver. Tim Hardaway on the attack. Stops and shoots. Misses. Simeon with the basketball and Hardaway with the foul.
Yes, he missed the shot and came over his shoulder. Tim, don't be mad if you're a Carver fan, because had he not fouled him, Knight was all alone on the other end of the court. It was about a layup time.
All right, here's the replay, Coach.
Now he comes in over his shoulder right there.
And if that ball had wound up in Eric David's possession, he was about to throw it down the other end of the floor.
There was nobody outside of the Simeon ball player in the offensive aftercourt.
Well, that's, of course, what Carver's got to do. They've got to crash the offensive board, make things happen. That's going to prevent some defensive weaknesses. Here's Eric David, averaging 12, scoring 9. And missing the first free throw, but the rebound to Nick Anderson. What a key rebound.
He's got two of them now off missed free throws. That's a Carver, that cannot happen to him.
Caleb Davis looking for the steal or the foul, one or the other. They're going to have to stop the clock. Eric David has the ball, and Davis does get his foul.
Yes.
It's a 1-1.
It's 1:03 to go in the ball game with the score 58-53. These are crucial. It's a strange incident where the second man on the free throw line has gotten both missed free throws. They have to sandwich him in. Don't let him get up there. They got all five men on the board, so the two men on each side should sandwich so that they can't rebound it.
Obviously, those balls that bounce high off the rim are an advantage for the offensive player in the middle there. And Nick Anderson is such a great leaper.
Well, Jenkins is right next to him. Jenkins can go up.
He sure can. Brad Warren is a new player in the game for Carver. He's number 44. And Eric David has just made the first of his two free throws.
We got a timeout by Carver.
Which is a smart call by Walters. Make him think about it.
Yes, it is. It's a six-point lead with a minute and 3 seconds to go. It's going to be tough for Carver to make that up because they don't get any charity baskets. Simeon seems to have controlled the boards. When you're losing like that, if you miss a shot, you got to be able to tip one in or gain possession again. And they're not getting anything on a fast break. Simeon gets back. They're very well-coached and well-schooled team.
These are two extremely well-disciplined teams. Coach Walters at Carver had to suspend a few of his players early in the year for disciplinary reasons just to show who's in charge. And obviously the team has rallied very well. You know, Ray, it's been speculated all over Chicago's basketball circles. How good would Simeon be had Ben Wilson not been tragically struck down? I think it's a moot point at this juncture, but it's sure a tribute to this Simeon team and the coaching staff that they've turned into such a wonderful team.
They could be the number one team in the nation.
Yes. Right.
You got to hand it to Walters. He doesn't have Simeon's talent.
Right.
But he stayed right in the ballgame. They've played very aggressively. They just don't have the talent of Simeon. Simeon can throw a sub here and a sub there, and he hasn't been able to do that. And he's done a few things differently in the second half and made a good run at him. But unfortunately, you foul the right man, and when you miss the free throw and they get the ball back, you're in trouble.
You see Coach Walter's record, which is a very impressive one, 74-37. Willie Little of Chicago, Illinois Chicago, has said that Bob Walters is the class of the public league, and Willie would know, he used to coach at Manly. Of course, Bob Hambrick, a very classy individual, too. His team now enjoying a seven-point lead. The ball is passed off the backboard, but Carver retains possession as it bounces back. High pass to Caleb Davis, up with the shot. Oh, he didn't bet it. He couldn't get it down.
Well, they're gambling again on that high lob going in. They have a big man on each side of the lane, and they're trying to throw it over the defense because it's a 1-3-1 zone, and they figure they got one man in the middle, and they're going to either side.
Simeon's got enough size down low, though, Coach. It's pretty hard to lob over them, especially with Nick Anderson in there.
Well, he's a very strong individual. He's well-built individual. He's not only size, he's got weight and strength to go with it.
Caleb Davis makes the free throw, and it's now 60-54 with 49 seconds to play.
Ooh, that's 11.
That'll do it. Here's Carver with one last shot. Off the back rim, no good. Simeon, the champions of the city of Chicago.
That's always the way. Look at this celebration, Tim. One team is happy, and that's what happens in the tournament. There's only one team that goes away happy.
There's Mrs. Wilson, all that sacrifice.